imagination can save you.
You just gotta get it in your head, kid.
Stop feeling sorry for yourself.
Don't say that to him.
What? It doesn't matter anyway.
He can't hear us.
Ah, yes. The plight of the narrator. We have all the information, and we know what's going to happen. And yet, sadly, the protagonist can never hear us.
I can hear you both.
Yes. We're so sorry about your parents, Jim.
Yeah, of all the ways Roald Dahl killed the parents on the first page,
he trampolines like rhinoceros is the worst, by far.
Who's Roald Dahl?
Don't worry about it.
They weren't even supposed to be at the zoo. They were in London, shopping for my birthday present. We're sorry, James. We never meant to abandon you.
If we'd known that Rhino was escaping the zoo, we never would have gone to the city that day.
We failed you.
No, you didn't. But I miss you both so much.
Shut up, sweetheart. Good things are coming.
What do you mean?
What things? You'll just have to trust us.
I believe in yourself, James.
I do trust you, but I don't know if I believe in myself.
Uh-oh. Look, Marta. Look behind you.
Why? Why did you have to leave me? With them? Mom? Dad?
Get to chopping, you disgusting brood.
Heavens, that wood's not going to chop itself.
What's the matter?
I miss my parents.
Stop crying immediately, you nasty beast. Your parents were idiots. They got themselves trampled by a rhino.
With all the stupid ways.
I will. Later. It's too hot right now. But get out of my sight, you disgusting, slimy worm!
Give us some peace. Listen to how Roald Dahl describes Aunt Sponge. She had small, piggy eyes, a sunken mouth, and was like a great soggy overboiled cabbage.
Listen to how he describes Aunt Spiker. She has a screeching voice and long, wet, narrow lips. And whenever she got angry or excited, little flecks of spit would come shooting out of her mouth as she died.
Two ghastly hags.
We don't actually have actors that ugly and terrible in this
movie. We have horrible characters such as Angela and Spiker. So we'll make do with the lovely and talented Evie Cogan and Juliet Cabotson.
What are you? coming to you live from Sponge and Spiker's garden. It's unlike anything the planet has ever seen.
Breaking news, exclusive. The crowds are wild with anticipation.
They're here for only one thing, Bill.
That's right, Sue. The giant peach.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Two horrible women capitalize off a fruity miracle.
Fruity miracle, you say? All I could use is a miracle.
Get it back in line. They usually sell out.
Fine, Sponge and Spiker. The saintly Sponge and Spiker.
I can't see. Move over.
I would have loved to.
Me first, you little friend.
I've been waiting an eye for three.
The trouble is, most people don't bother to count them. They just take his word for it. And anyway, what's so horrible? frivolous about having a lot of money.
Poor fellow. He's not. Can't say I'm
smarter than him. The really, truly marvelous thing is to have no legs at all and still be able to walk.
You call that walking? You're a slither, that's all you are. You just slither along.
I glide.
You are a slimy beast.
I am not a slimy beast. I am a helpful and much loved creature. Ask any guardian you like. As for you,
I am a pest.
He is so proud of that. Don't you like me? I cannot understand why.
I am the best of the story. Unless you count grasshopper, he is long past his prime.
I have never been a pest in my life. I am a musician.
When I was 15, 16, when I really started to play guitar, I definitely wanted to become a musician. It was almost impossible because the dream was so big that I didn't see any chance because I was living in a little town, was studying, and when I finally broke away from school and became a musician, I thought, well, now I may have a little bit of a chance. Because all I really wanted to do is music, and not only play music, but compose music. At that time in Germany, in 69, 70, they had already discotheques. So I would take my car, would go to a discotheque, sing maybe 30 minutes. I think I had about 7-8 songs. I would partially sleep in the car, because I didn't want to drive home. And that helped me for about almost 2 years to survive in the beginning. I wanted to do an album with the sounds of the 50s, the sounds of the 60s, of the 70s, and then have a sound of the future. And I said, wait a second, I know the synthesizer. Why don't I use the synthesizer, which is the sound of the future? And I didn't have any idea what to do, but I knew I needed a click, so we put a click on the 24 track, which then was synced to the Moog modular. I knew that could be a sound of the future, but I didn't realize how much the impact would be. My name is Giovanni Giorgio, but everybody calls me Giorgio.
She's not really a worm at all. She's a fly.
James and his companions crouched close together on top of the peach as the night began closing around them.
This is the part of the story where things get really strange.
Wait, this is the strange part? Not the giant flying beach? Not the enormous bugs?
Excuse me, technically I'm the raptor.
Pardon me, Spider.
What a common mistake, really.
Clouds like mountains tower high over their head, mysterious, menacing, and overwhelming.
A pale moon came up over the clouds and cast an eerie light over the whole sea.
Thank you.
were terrifying.
It's okay, Ladybug. We're all right now.
And they don't seem to be following us.
I wonder where we're going. I think we're headed west. Lower. Light the way.
This must be the Atlantic Ocean. We're not in England anymore.
Thank you.
stuck right there till an hour comes. If it's full of it, looking like a bomb. My girls got city to run, got the key to the kingdom where the money's from. Never seen the color yellow, never seen the sun.
And he thinks I'm the native one.
Flags flapping in my hand. New job, New York. Gargoyles gargling on. Peak of the empire, top of the rock. Flags flapping in my hand. New job, New York. Gargoyles gargling on. Peak of the empire, top of the rock.
My girl's got a little shtick. You could have been the kitchen when I feed a kid. Keep you waiting in the window while I touch your tits. My girl got a limousine. Got a full-time job just to keep it clean. Got a speaker in the trunk, you know where it's done.
You think I'm the negative one?
Thank you.
see a vast, enormous city glistening in the early morning sunshine that sprawled 3,000 feet away.
Look, I think there's land below.
What in the world is that above?
How on earth are we supposed to get down from here?
You see that thing? It's going down
here!
I don't think it will be too hard. All we have to do is cut loose a couple of seagulls.
Are those seagulls?
Are those
insects?
Thank you. suppose that's true. Hi.
And this is Ladybug, but we call her Ladybird. This is Spider. She can spin bread strong enough to lift peaches across the land.
Aw, thank you, James.
And this is Silver. She never tires of helping her friends when they are in need.
Tired? Me?
And this is Glowworm. Although Glowworm is not a worm at all. Glowworm is a fly. What a lovely green light. Thank you.
And this is James. He's the best friend anyone could ever ask for. With a big problem-solving genius.
With a big heart.
He's a great listener. And he's very brave.
And he never makes you feel ashamed or embarrassed.
And he always cheers you on and makes you feel good about yourself. And he always makes you feel proud of yourself. Wow, James, can I be your friend too?
I would love that.
James, will you tell us your story?
Tell us all about your adventures.
Please, James, tell us about the giant peak.
Yes, James, tell us.
And thus the journey ended. But the travelers lived on. Every one of them became rich and successful in the new country.
The centipede was made vice president, in charge of sales for a high-class boot and shoe maker.
The earthworm, her lovely blue skin, was employed as a spokesperson for fixing things.
I'm in television commercials. Have you seen me?
Spider and Silkworm are in business today. They make ropes for tape reporters in three factories.
In Brooklyn.
The Glowworm became the light inside of the Statue of Liberty, and thus saved a grateful city from having to pay a huge electric bill every year.
You're welcome. The old green grasshopper opened a disco club downtown. He can be found there playing several nights a week.
And Ladybird.
Oh, hey! I do!
Ladybird married Clark. They bought a house on Staten Island, and they lived happily ever after.
And as for our hero, James Henry Charles.
Oh, can I tell?
Sure.
James moved into the peach pit. He turned it into a lovely little cottage, and the city permanently placed it in the central part as a famous monument.
All you have to do any day of the week was to knock on the doors, and the doors would be open.
Every day, hundreds and hundreds of little children came from far and near to this marvelous peach stone cottage.
And if you remember, the one sad, lonely little boy named James now found himself surrounded by friends and companions that begged him always to tell the stories of his adventures on the giant peach.
So James thought it would be nice to write it down and turn the story into a book.
So he wrote it.
And that is what you have just finished reading.